Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time.
Good morning.
And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer,
with your morning flash update for this Thursday, the 14th of December, 2017, about 9:15 a.m. Central Standard Time. A lot of economic data came out today. I'll get to that in a minute. Central bank data came out. At this point, it's lifting the dollar still at the expense of other currencies. Just about every major central bank that met today has left their interest rates unchanged with no intent at this point of even raising them anytime soon. We're talking the Bank of England, Swiss National Bank, European Central Bank, Norway's Central Bank. It goes on and on. And that leaves the U.S. by itself still as the one currency that is looking at higher interest rates with a gradual path of increases as much as 3 next year. As we take a look at the metal markets, you can see basically what is going on right now as you're getting a little bit of a lift in them. But I think these are crucial numbers right here. If the markets can't advance between this, you got to look on your charts. You're in a resistance zone. Notice that we've made a change to the March stock indices. The rolls now, the Decembers go off the board tomorrow, so keep your eye on that. Bitcoin down under 17,000 right now. They are going to allow from Interactive Broker short selling. It's the first big brokerage firm that's been allowing their customers to trade in this, and they're going to allow short selling. Of course, you got to put up 5 times the margin. You heard what I said. Let's assume that they've added to their regular margins, not what the exchange is doing. Now they're going to want 5 times that. Nobody knows the value if this thing takes off to the upside. That's the problem, because it's esoteric in its own way. Even with the cold weather, if you're watching the news out east, you're not lifting natural gas. Still too much supply there. Sort of a dead man bounce in the grains right here. Not an awful lot going there. The IEA came out and talked that maybe the production coming out of the U.S. next year in oil, the first 6 months, is going to be so large it sort of ruins the party for OPEC, as they're keeping their cuts in place and the U.S. is just going to crank out all the way that it can. So that'll be interesting. I'm going to put that in my reports today and give you some ideas about what they're talking. We look at U.S. business inventories down 1/10, right with what they expected. Sales, though, down 6. They were up 6/10 versus the prior month's gain of 1.4%. So they gained, but not as much as the prior month. The ratio is about normal. The market, U.S. preliminary service sector PMI, came out at 52.4. That's a bit lower than they were looking for at 54.4, and that stalled the dollar for a little bit. The U.S. preliminary December manufacturing sector PMI, 55 versus an expected 53.8. So you got a little bit of a lift there. Yeah, import-export prices up 7/10, right in line with what they wanted to on the import, but the export went up more than the market was looking for, about 4 times more. And petroleum import prices, well, you know that we've seen a big rally. So to see it go up from where it was before, 1.7% to up 7.2% this month, that makes all the sense because you've been lifting there. Jobless claims data came in down 11,000. Expected it right where it came in at 235. You were down to 27,000 on the jobless claims on the continuing. ECB policy statement, Bank of England and the other banks, just about where we all expected them to be, pretty much unchanged. Stock market for a change, not really rallying an awful lot. So I keep my eyes on things today. Our chart of the day, I want to go back to what this is. We now put this inside of our charting services. But what this is all about is getting price counts. Now, what a price count is so many of you watch me talk about swing lines during my afternoon reviews. And it's, think of swing lines on steroids mixed with a form of Fibonacci. Once a trend kicks in, where might it go? That's what they're about. It's not about telling you a trend is kicked in, but if the trend is kicked in, where might the market go? We put out one of these a day, and now we're also putting out our price count services, where we put out on the weekends a lot of them. I'm going to start doing the financial markets for the company now every weekend. So give you an idea of what those counts are. If you'd like to try this, you should. Give us a call. Go to our website. You'll see a carousel of free offers. Sign up for the chart of the day. You can click up here if you're watching me on YouTube. Or underneath us, it says click here for IRIS free offers on many websites. I'm Ira Epstein. You have yourselves a great day. I will catch you all in the afternoon. Take care now.